theater friends. My name is Andrew. Welcome to Thursday Thoughts. Thursday Thoughts is a series of videos where I talk about some of my thoughts about things about musical theater. Sometimes it'll be a song, sometimes it'll be a show, a character, a particular songwriter, a situation, anything really that comes to mind. It's a little bit of a catch-all for things I want to talk about on this channel that don't fit into one of the other categories. Today's Thursday Thoughts is about the song I Remember Sky, or I Remember, from Evening Primrose. Evening Primrose is a 1966 musical film with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim and with a book by James Goldman. It follows the story of Charles, who is a poet, who takes refuge one night in a department store and discovers a group of people that have been hiding out in that department store for 13 years. He meets a young woman named Ella. They sort of fall in love with each other. And this song, I Remember, is Ella talking about the fact that she hasn't been out into the outside world since she was 6 years old. She's 19 now. And she's talking about the world as she remembers them, as she remembers it when she was six. It's a beautiful, haunting song. It's got a beautiful sort of form and structure. It constantly comes back to this theme. I remember sky, or whatever it is that she's remembering. Remember sky. It was clear as it was blue as ink, and then it you know, as her memories and as her thoughts keep her going, it moves into different musical areas. It moves into completely different musical material, and then something brings her back to remembering the next thing, where the music comes back to this sort of A. The classical musician might call this a bit of a, I guess, a rondo form. I don't think it's quite so strict in that regard, but I do like that we sort of come back to this this theme. One of the other great features of this music is this sort of anxiety-provoking repetition that happens. So, for example, soft as feathers, sharp as thumbtacks, coming down like wind, and it just drives home this idea that this sort of anxiety about the current situation that is so prevalent in this story, in this show. I think Evening Primrose is so relatable to us today. Yes. Many of us, most of us, can go outside, can go for walks, so it's not that we've lost the ability to see the sky or the trees or anything like that, but we have found ourselves trapped in a place, and some of us are handling it much better than others, and some of us are not handling it as well. And if the latter is you, I encourage you to reach out and talk to people about it, and find art that reflects how you're feeling and that helps you to sort of process and deal with that loss, whatever your loss looks like. For some people it's loss of freedom, for some people it's loss of a loved one, for some people it's loss of their livelihood. But I encourage you to reach out and to acknowledge that through art with other people as much as you can. One of the things I also really love about this song is the way that it ends. So, and at times I think I would gladly die. And it ends on that. Yes, it ends on a tonic chord. Yes, it ends on the C chord in C major and all that good stuff. But it doesn't end sort of finally. It doesn't settle on that tonic note. It doesn't have that traditional musical theater thing of that sort of bump at the end. It just kind of ends in a way. It resolves, but it doesn't have that sort of note of finality. And I think that really speaks to Sondheim's wonderful way of creating this sort of haunting unresolvedness about the whole situation in this show. And that's all the way through the music. The harmonies are so rich, but rich in a way that's different from much of his other work. There's so many sort of minor keys with extra little semitones that resolve outward or things like that. But it's you know. It's just so rich and there's a humanity to this music that I really, really love. And now enjoy I Remember Sky from Evening Primrose. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you've enjoyed my thoughts on this song. If you have enjoyed this song, or if you find something intriguing about this song, I really encourage you to look into Evening Primrose a little bit more. It's a fascinating, fascinating show. And I really, it's one of Sondheim's, I think, less discovered gems. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and consider subscribing to my channel. The next video coming out on Monday, May 25th, is going to be our first mashup Mondays. It's going to be a little bit of a surprise, but if you enjoy unexpected combinations of songs together, then definitely keep an eye out for that. Like I said, please like this video, subscribe to my channel if you want to have more updates from me.